हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ आकाश मिश्र हियर एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग मेक इजी। एंड इन दैट चैनल इन दिस चैनल आई मेक्स वीडियोज फॉर आवर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड दैट विल बी बेनिफिशियल फॉर यू। एंड नाउ वी आर मूविंग विथ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग। दिस इज 41st लेक्चर एंड वी आर मूविंग टू कवर ऑल द सिलेबस ऑफ गेट। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ आवर दिस लेक्चर, बट बिफोर दैट प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड इफ यू आर एंजॉइंग माई सेशन देन प्लीज लेट मी नो इन कमेंट बॉक्स ऑल्सो। ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड वन न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज जिग्स एंड फिक्स्चर्स। इन दैट वी टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू मूव विथ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सिक्स पॉइंट लोकेशन। वॉट इज दैट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सिक्स पॉइंट लोकेशन? दैट इज द अनदर नेम इज द नथिंग बट 3-2-1 प्रिंसिपल। ओके, वॉट एग्जैक्टली दैट इज? द वर्क पीस इज कंप्लीटली रिस्ट्रेंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ 3 locating points on one plane, 2 locating points on another plane and 1 locating point on next plane. Okay, if there are for every body there will be 6 planes. Okay, likewise 1, 2, 3, 4 and one backside and one front side, likewise 6 planes will be there. And from that 6 planes we will select any 3 planes, and on that 3 planes, on the one plane there will be 3 points, on another plane there will be 2 points and remaining plane 1 point for locating. Okay, so if we have stated total 6 points, that is nothing but 3 plus 2 plus 1 on 3 consecutive planes, and that locator points will locate the workpiece. So ultimately from all the directions the workpiece will be restrained there. The workpiece will have now 0 degree of freedom. Okay, so what exactly that is? This is 3 coordinate system, that is x, y, z, and in that we have drawn this one cube. Okay, so in that there is one bottom plane, on that we have located 3 points. Okay, you can change these 3 points here, here, or you can take any plane. Just for example, I have taken on the bottom plane, I have stated 3 locators. Okay, and that plane which is backside here, that is nothing but YZ plane. On that plane I have stated 2 locators or 2 locating points, and on XY plane I have stated 1 locating point. Okay, so ultimately this will satisfy the principle of 6 point location or 3-2-1 principle, and with the help of this all 6 points the workpiece will be totally restrained. The degree of freedom of workpiece now will be 0. Okay, and this principle is used in jigs and fixtures, because ultimately the aim of jigs and fixtures is to fix the workpiece, to allow to guide the tool, etc., etc. So in that, to fix workpiece is also one function of jigs and fixtures. Okay, so that's why the principle of 6-point location is used while design of jigs and fixtures. So this is very basic principle, but too much understanding for us. Okay, too much important. So note down the name, then draw this figure. If possible you can make any one sentence for what exactly it is. That sentence may be: workpiece can be completely restrained with the help of 3 location points in one plane, 2 location points in another plane and 1 location point in third plane. Okay, likewise you can make one sentence. Then we will move towards another point, that is locating devices or locators. As here we have seen that we have to implement 6 locators, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 6 locators we have located. So what exactly that locators? Locators is nothing but locating devices, means for locate the workpiece, for fix the workpiece, we will have some devices like support pins and etc. That we will look what exactly that. But before that, we will firstly consider the factors for selection of locator, which type of locator or locating device we have to select. And then how we are going to select that, which factors we have to take into care. Okay, so just we will look the factors for selection of locator. Okay, factors for selection of locators. There are different types of locators, but which locator we have to select, that depends on different factors. So that factors we are going to consider. That factors are shape and size of workpiece. First factor is shape and size of workpiece. As shape and size of workpiece will vary, the locators we will need, that will vary. Then next is operation performed on workpiece. they because of operation, if there is drilling operation, if there is cutting operation, if there is shaping operation or etc., depending on that also the stresses is going to apply on workpiece, that will vary. And if the stresses on workpiece will vary, ultimately that locators we have to use, that also we have to change, because there may be chances that any locator is there and that is not going to take that shear stress, but that is very good for compressive stress. Likewise, for if there is any workpiece that is satisfying the compressive stress, then for that we have to use that locator. Likewise, the types of locator changes according to size, shape and operation. After that, the quantity and quality of workpiece to be produced, then surface finish and accuracy. These are some points, these are factors for selection of locators. Then we will move towards types of locators. Okay, types of locators. There are different types of locators like support pins and jack pins. Support pins and jack pins means simply pin will be there and that will support. Means if this is workpiece, then from bottom there may be one pin and that will only support. That pin is not connected to workpiece directly, only the surface contact is there. Okay, then next is locating pins, then next is V locators. V locator you may have seen. Okay, the workpiece will be placed here. This is nothing but V locator. Okay, then next is boost locator, then diamond pin locator. These are some types of locators that I have given you here idea. That types are not too much important also, but you should know the names of all the types of locators. In that, the V locator and first what I have said to you, that is nothing but support pins and jack pins. That two types of locators are commonly used in industry. Okay, so this is all about what I have designed for today's lecture, and now we will move towards our last topic of discussion, that is nothing but bonus point. So if you have enjoyed my session, then please like, share and subscribe, and we will move, that is nothing but clamping devices. Okay, we have seen the locators, we have seen jigs and fixtures, that 3-2-1 principle, but after that locators we will need some clamping devices also. So which kind of clamping devices are there, like lever clamps, then screw clamp, then latch clamp, hinge clamp. You may have seen one C clamp in our lab. There is one section like C and here the screw will be there. Okay, this is C clamp. These kind of clamping devices are there for clamp. If there is no any special jigs and fixtures have been designed for any operation, then we will just use these clamps for fixing the workpiece. Okay, so this is basic purpose of clamp, and different types of clamps like lever clamps, screw clamp, latch clamp, hinge clamp. This is C clamp. This is one of the example of screw clamp, because here we are using one screw. Okay, so this is all about clamping devices, jigs and fixtures. And now in next lecture also we will continue with jigs and fixtures, like types of jigs and etc. So we will meet again. Thank you friends. Please like, share and subscribe. If you have any suggestion, then let me know in comment box. Thank you friends.